And as you know, with the borders opening up on the 1st of December, there's a lot of economic activity that's now kicking along, in particular with the tourism in the industry kicking off. And as you know, because of tourism, nearly 40% of our GDP gets rejuvenated. In the next few weeks, you'll see a lot more tourists coming through. And it has a spillover effect. It's not only about the hotels, but it's also those people who are dependent on the livelihoods of those people who are directly working in the hotel industry. So to give you an example, if somebody may be selling, you know, mitai or boiled evi outside the Fiji Airways office or Fiji Airways headquarters or outside the airports, they actually sell their goods and food to those people who work there. But when the airport is not operational, when Fiji Airways is not flying, obviously those people aren't working there, and these people then don't have their business. So similarly, of course, once we see the opening of this at a lot more higher speed and indeed frequency, you'll see a lot more activity. It has a spillover effect on this side of the island too. And I think generally whenever there is some form of an economic downturn, whether it's a pandemic, whether it's a global financial crisis, whether it's general economic slowdown in a country, businesses that actually invest when the economy is down by having a foresight, they're the ones who actually reap the benefits the most. And I think in this particular instance, I know that the benefits that the owners of this particular enterprise, Ali and his family, will do will be quite significant. Because a lot of people were hesitant to invest, and he's made that investment at a time when the market was a bit slow. So this will give people the opportunity. People have been in lockdowns, people have various restrictions, so they want to get out of it. They want to be able to enjoy themselves. You know, this gentleman here, our MC, was talking about entertainment. The same way the AGs conference on the weekend, the people, you know, who play the instruments in the band, who sing songs, they have not had a job for nearly 18 months. Hotels weren't open, they could not go to even restaurants to sing, but now they can. And people like that who are now being re-engaged, they will also want to come and get themselves entertained, whether to play a game of pool or whether to, you know, just come down and relax with friends. And so I think this is a very opportune investment, a very opportune time to make this investment. We'd like to wish the investors all the best, the family, Ali and his family, all the best. I'm sure it's a family, you know, initiative, and we look forward to your support in helping him, because these are the small businesses. Small businesses like this, there's literally hundreds or if not thousands of small businesses, and they engage people. They may, you know, employ two people, three people, five people, and they are one of the largest group of employers. So it's critically important that these businesses thrive, not only for them to make a profit and do well, but also to be able to create a lot more economic activity and create those livelihoods back again. So, ladies and gentlemen, we wish you, we all together wish the investments, all the investors, all the best. I'm sure some of you will come and make use of it. Those of you who do not drink Yamona, at least you'll come and play a game of pool, or just come down, sit here, and relax with your friends. And you know, we hope that a lot more people will come and use these facilities. So, instead of making a very long speech, please put your hands together for our investors here and the family and those, all those who supported him. And we look forward to your business doing well. God willing. Thank you.
Another great hands for our global...